It's late summer and time to migrate down to the Great Salt Flats of Bonneville to see the fastest cars and bikes in the world. This time it's particularly exciting because we're not just going to look, but to actually ride in the course in a race against time. Who knows, maybe we'll set new speed records ourselves. The salt flats are dazzling, miles and miles of flat, white salt. Without these orange cones, I might get lost and never get out of here. We find a place to set up shop, wide enough for two cars and easy drive through for Daryl and the trailer. Dozer's been riding for a long time, so we give him a walk around the pits. You might think that the salt would be boiling hot, but it's actually almost cool to the touch, so his feet won't get burned. He's a popular guy with the pit folks.
He'll christen it for us. There we go.
Look, my beautiful husband went to the store to get tonic in order to make me a vodka tonic. That is true love, and I am grateful to him for that. Thank you, sweetheart. Would you believe that in here is the most precious jewel? It is something I would never, never, ever buy for myself. It is a battery for my camera. Yay! And a spare battery for my camera, which is important because my battery often goes dead. So, thank you. Again, here we are. We are not at a truck stop. No, we're not camping out. We are in a luxurious room at the Motel 6 right here in Wendover, Nevada. Right down the street is a casino that I can go and pop some quarters in the slot machines. So take after my mother. And I'm having a wonderful time. So, it's a great birthday. Welcome to 72 years, Nadine.
Daryl, Cynthia, and the race vehicle pull into the pits, and we start to get things ready to race. The temperature and altitude here are different from Dallas, so it'll take a bit of mixture tuning to get the most power out of that engine. At last, it comes to life. Had me worried for a while there.
Daryl is truly his father's son. An exacting, focused, detail-oriented engineer with a patient, even-tempered attitude. It's an honor and a pleasure to be part of his team and watch him in action.
Everybody has a job, and Nadine puts up shades and Cynthia puts numbers on the beast. Daryl continues to tweak the engine. The first official thing to do is the driver's meeting, just to find out all the do's and don'ts for riding on the course.
This is the highlight of our year, at least it is for me, so it's good to see everyone.
It's really important that the chase truck going to pick up the vehicles don't get on the active course. Next, it's tech inspection to see that everything is safe and meet the specifications. Here they're looking at our competition, a streamlined motorcycle with a sidecar. I think it may be just a little faster than us, probably more expensive too.
It does give you a significant cushion on the helmet.
A big man can squeeze into this tight place, but can he get a helmet on too?
Our number means we're a sidecar scooter with a turbocharged engine, less than 100 cc's, running special fuels. Not many in that class. Our tech inspection goes fine. We meet all the requirements. Have you been accommodated?
Yeah, you better stay there and get a picture.
Yeah. Now it's Daryl's turn to prove all his time, energy, and money invested in this little boy is well spent. Seems sort of strange to be wearing an all-black leather suit on such a sunny, hot day, but it's really hard to find a white one.
Getting suited up in leather suit, boots, helmet, and gloves takes longer than the actual ride, and suiting up is not a simple process either. You need patient crew assistance, and Cynthia is a pro.
Now's the moment we've been waiting for. First trial run on the salt. With a powerful throb of many horses, the scooter thunders down the long white course.
Pete suggests a suit of white leather, but watching Daryl pulling away, I'm thinking, white leather on a white scooter on white salt? Maybe not so good. We could lose Daryl forever out there.
After a 2.25-mile run, Daryl turns off the course and we meet him with the trailer.
Cynthia has had a lot of practice being crew chief. Watch how she uses mind control to get that scooter back on the trailer.
The speed is not as good as he wanted, so he'll do a little tweaking and try again, and try again, and try again he does. Let's see if all this tuning is working. Triumph!
Yes, sir.
Did we get 49 again?
Nope. Slow down.
Doesn't sound like I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe you went the wrong way.
Hey, get out of that suit.
Okay.
I need the,
Despite the tuning setback, Daryl thinks the machine is safe and strong enough for an old man to ride. That means I've got to struggle into my black leather suit, too. I'm used to riding my motorcycle on and off roads. But this new vehicle will be a strange thing for me. Never been on a sidecar bike before. I've got some reservations about this nonsense. Is this really on my bucket list?
You know, when a guy needs help getting his
Daryl,
pants
come over
on,
here and help your dad.
Well, it gives his wife a little worry.
This is my first time on the scooter, and I know it's going to feel different from a motorcycle. I just don't know how different.
It's okay, he's got his jacket on anyway.
But there's no backing out now. Too many people watching.
Are you cool enough in there?
It keeps the heat off of me. That's why.
All right, well.
What do you have set for?
It's set for whatever it can get, which is right now about a half to 1 pound. That's all that the engine doesn't have the capacity to.
How fast are you going now?
I don't know, I'm louder than the speaker sound.
I love this shot. The family white off to the starting line. You're looking at bonding in action here.
Harder is better.
I'm going for a world record.
Any last?
This is going to be a personal best.
Any last words?
My last words in testicle?
Yes.
Well, going fast.
Go for it. Another question. Are you nervous?
Am I nervous? No, not me.
Good.
I'm nervous.
It's going to be fun.
It's going to be fun.
Goes, conquering all fears, zooming along at record high speeds, and returning to his people successfully.
I did it. Not too fast to scare me, just fast enough to get the thrill.
Two hands! Yay!
You still have all your fingers, all five of them.
A surge of triumph.
Wait a minute, I don't...
ran through my body.
Really?
And I broke the 30 mile an hour barrier. And I could feel the sonic boom.
Hey, what? Top speed, 32.5.
Yeah.
I see this.
Did you have it full throttle?
A couple of times.
Have a what?
Did you have it full throttle?
A couple of times?
I gave it a couple of throttles, full throttles, with a full of throttles, yeah.
And then backed off.
But I digress here to look at an incredible performance by Denise Mueller, who rides her bicycle to 148 miles an hour behind this specially modified Range Rover.
This awesome lady is actually beating her own record here. She's upped her speed over 20 miles per hour.
She's towed up to about 100 miles an hour, then she goes on her own power to 148 miles an hour. All the while, of course, staying in the windshield of the car. What a cranker. That girl's got legs. Now here's a real streamliner with two big V8 engines, looking to go 550 miles an hour. There goes $1 million. Unfortunately, they have an accident within the first quarter mile and break the drive shaft.
Best laid plans. Sadly, they can go awry. Target 550. We'll have to go back to the repair shop and maybe even back to the design drawing board.
More tuning so I can make another run.
Thank you.
feels like riding down a rough dirt road.
Pour it on, Pete.
Another sidecar competitor starts with a Harley frame and motor. That redhead ended up going about 116 miles an hour. Sophisticated bike with a sidecar is this super streamliner with a Suzuki Hayabusa motor. It had a hard time starting up from a full stop, but winds up with a land speed record of 273 miles an hour. Wow. My last run comes up quick, but we're ready to go. This is for the record books. So I better put the pedal to the metal. Triumph! A new land speed record. Hold your breath here, folks. 38.315 miles an hour. Almost, but not quite supersonic. A final tech inspection to assure that everything is according to spec. And we don't have an overboard big BMW engine in it. Measuring the dimensions of the cylinder.
Put your top towards me. Toward you this way.
Daryl's turn again to test and more tuning options. He'll keep at this until he finds the right combination.
Squared away?
Yep.
The other direction in jets. Friction it up a little bit and see how that works.
Daryl does run after run, tweaking this and that. It's a pretty frustrating day for him, owner, operator, and chief mechanic. It doesn't help that he's getting emails from his day job with urgent requests. Best attitude now. Tomorrow's another day.
It was imperfect.
It was imperfect.
Looks like it's getting better to get a top speed of 46 miles an hour. Dozer is pretty unimpressed by all this activity. We can see what happens when a tire blows at about 400 miles an hour. What's this? We're registering another rider? It can't be Nadine. She's a 72-year-old grandmother. But sure enough, she's gonna give it a try. Good luck. She can wear my leathers. As
a pretty little flower bed of white gardenias. But parked in a rickety old garage is a brand new shiny red super stock car. And everybody's saying that there's nobody meaner than the pretty old lady from Pasadena.
So you'll see the square markers on the side. And just sort of stay to the right side of the track. It's a little bit smoother on the right-hand side.
Okay.
Plus, if it dies, then you'll have
to be closer to the marker.
Closer to walking.
Yeah.
So just go. You'll see the markers, marker, 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 and then you'll see a one marker. So go all the way through that, and then you can sort of sit up, and you'll see the next one will be a Q, which is the one in the quarter. So just sort of slow down.
A little bit of fear. A little bit of
that's right, you're riding a scooter.
A little nervousness that makes you
at possibly 40 miles per hour.
Yeah. it's the high speed. Don't go supersonic here in the first try.
Okay.
I don't actually want to go supersonic, but honestly, I do want to go as fast as this little machine will take me. And I do.
You're still tethered.
Okay. That was way fun.
You did it.
You did it. Perfect.
You are a land speed racer.
Yeah. You were born. Born to race.
I am. I could get into
that. That's it.
It was like...
You seem to say
that a lot. I have to say,
that
was like the first time I had sex. That's it. Got better as time. Oh, it was really fun. Really fun.
Really fun.
Yeah, it's sort of like it's like getting to that first mile. It's like, come on, hurry up. Where is that one mile mark? So,
hey.
Because I knew I was going to go 2 miles. I had it pegged all the way.
Yeah.
Once I passed one.
Now for the second run to verify the speed. She has a great run. And makes a record speed of 43.822 miles an hour. I always knew she was a fast woman. As a world record holder for speed, what's your favorite beer that makes you go fast?
Well, it's Target 55.
Is that your age or your speed?
Well, it's add a couple, add 100 pounds, and it's sort of my weight, so. You know, my favorite beer is whatever there is available, but I want to tell you, I'm hooked on racing. Or at least at Bonneville, where you're not really racing, you're racing against the clock. So it was fun. It was really, really fun. I'm just glad I did it. I kind of held back for a while, like, oh no. But once I got these leathers on, I was like, yahoo, I'm a leather lady. So, that's it.
Just our luck to have a big rainstorm overnight. Next morning, our campsite is flooded to make the slickest, stickiest, gooeyest mud. We slip and slide and barely make it out of the place. On the salt flats, it's a great surprise to see the rain just puddle up and not soak in. Might as well be cast concrete. Because of the rain, there's no more racing this week. It's time to head home. We're happy to leave here with two of the world's slowest land speed records. But we've got a ton of desire to come back next year.